Motions have been watching your films for many years now. What is the secret for your success? Is it talent, intelligence, luck, or all of these?
I think it's about being at the right place at the right time. I've been extremely fortunate that when I started my career in the early 70s, it was the time when what is known as the parallel cinema was also taking shape. And I started with a film called Ankur, which became a very big hit, both nationally and internationally, won me my first national award. And from then onwards, I've been very fortunate that directors and writers have cast me in very strong roles that are so diverse that I've had an opportunity to be able to play many different varied characters, which normally you don't get within what is called mainstream cinema.
Okay. So you're saying strong roles, Shabana Azmi, you're known to be one among the rare actresses at that time to be doing controversial roles or self or real life roles. So what explained your choices at that time?
Well, firstly, I come from a family that believes art should be used as an instrument for social change. My father was a member of the Communist Party, a leftist poet, a member of the Progressive Writers Association. Till the age of 9, I lived in a commune, which is basically a small little room, which was 225 square feet. 8 families shared one toilet and one bathroom. But money was never the problem we had. Really extremely, extremely respected people from the art world, from the world of poetry, who were around us and were talking about values which were liberal, which were about social justice, which was about equality for women. And so it was inevitable that I would move towards a cinema with a social message.
Another your controversial role was playing a lesbian in Fire, and that also was subject to much protest. So how did you react?
When I did the film, I realized that there would be a section of the audience that would probably be shocked by the film. But I also reasoned that India is not a monolith and not everybody reacts in the same way. And so I thought that some people would be moved, some would be confused, some would be angry. But that there would be a variety of responses, but there would be a response. And I think the first way of dealing with an issue is first putting it on the table and say it exists and let's see how we examine it. For me, Fire was not only about a same-sex relationship. It was really looking at marital structure within the joint family system and saying that when we come across people whom we consider the other religion, the other race, the other country, maybe if we can empathize with the two women in Fire, then that empathy can be extended to the other, to the minority, to the oppressed, etc. And that's exactly what Fire did. The protests which were staged came from a political party to try and draw mileage out of it because they said that it's against Indian culture, etc. But the fact is civil society reacted so strongly to it and said that political party isn't going to determine for us what we are going to see or what we are going to hear or write or read. Because it had already been passed by the Board of Film Certification. And it was wonderful that the film came back into the theatres and became a cult film of sorts. And even now, so many years later, I go to so many universities and they talk about Fire as an extremely brave film.
You're talking about being at the right place at the right time. There are families who traditionally reign over Bollywood. We know about the Akhtar Azmi film family. Those who do not have necessary connections nowadays must be more talented or smart to be successful.
You know, I think that too much is made of this because obviously people who belong to film families have a foothold, which is an advantage. But just that foothold doesn't guarantee your success. What guarantees your success is your own talent and your own ability. So there have been instances when children of very famous parents in the industry have not made it good. And there have been many instances of people who were completely considered outsiders. And yet they came on the strength of their talent and have made it big. So for me, as an actor, I think it is very, very important that if you aspire to be an actor, then you must get training for it. There are lots of actors who say, but Amitabh Bachchan never went for training. Dilip Kumar never went for training. Yes, but they learned from the job. But can you imagine that if with that immense talent that they had, they also had the advantage of training? It was India. I am a product of the fact that I had Professor Roshan Taneja as my guru, as my teacher. And I think talent is God-given. I don't think you can learn talent. But if you have talent, then you can hone it like you polish diamond. And I would say for people who increasingly want to be in the movies that it's not good enough to have a pretty face and to be able to dance well and to have a good physique. But what is important is to observe life and to be connected to life. Because if you're connected to life, then your characters will be based on.
Among the young generation of actors and actresses, which one of them impresses you in mainstream cinema and in independent cinema?
Well, you can accuse me of nepotism if you want, but I do think Farhanandar is a very good actor. I'm very proud of the work that he does. And Nawazuddin, is also working in some mainstream films, but honestly, the work that he's doing is quite outstanding. Amongst the female actors, I like Vidya Balan very much. I think she's done some groundbreaking work. I think Deepika Padukone is doing a lot of work. In fact, I think that the general standard of acting both amongst the males and the females has improved very greatly.
So one of my next question is, most of the actresses today are getting bolder in mainstream, be it in their way of dressing, doing sex scenes, kissing scenes. And you as a veteran actress, how do you view this change, this...
See, I think it's slightly complex and it's complicated, and we need to understand it. Because celebrating a woman's sensuality is fine. But what is happening is, under the guise of celebrating sensuality, women are being objectified and they're being commodified, particularly in what is called the item number. I think one has to be very wary of that and make a choice. I'm no one to make a choice for you. This is what you want to do. I'm just saying be informed. Be informed that ultimately, when you allow yourself to be objectified and commodified, and then you participate in a song that has lyrics that are not desirable, it's also leading to the sexualization of children. And so do you want to hold yourself responsible for that or not? It's a choice that you have to make. Be informed is what I've been saying.
What legacy will you leave behind as a woman, as an actress, and as an activist?
The motto of my school was play the game. And I hope people remember me as somebody who played the game with the rules intact.
And Azmi, thank you very much.